what some are calling a solution to the housing affordability problem. Good morning, I'm Dan Mitchinson. It's 5:31. Home buying market is out of hand, and home prices in the Bay Area have gone up and up and up, about 18%, in fact, in the last year. The typical home in the Bay Area at about $1.3 million. So some millennials and others are turning to co-buying homes or buying a home with a friend or maybe even a group of friends to live in together. Good idea, bad idea? Well, we'll find out now as we head to the KCBS Ring Central Newsline. Kate McCann joins us, a realtor at Philly Home Girls, who just bought her own home with a friend. Hey, so what made you decide to do this, Kate?
So it was actually a vacation home that we decided to go in together about 4 years ago. And, you know, I was only 25 at the time. I couldn't afford my own second home. So when three of us did it together, it made it a much more affordable option.
Why the need for a second home, though, if you couldn't afford it on your own? What did you want to use this for?
It was just a dream I wanted to fulfill. I think a lot of millennials don't see, you know, life as such a clear-cut path, and it's something that the three of us wanted to do together, and we knew we could do it together, so it became an option for us.
So walk us through the process about this. I mean, is it easier to get a mortgage this way, or is it more difficult?
It's definitely much more complicated. There's a lot of hoops to jump through because they're looking at three people's income. But, you know, once you get pre-approved, it doesn't become much more difficult when the actual home buying process begins.
And what was the pre-approval process like for you and your friend?
Well, it was a bit complicated since the other two women I own it with are both business owners. So, you know, they're looking at their tax returns as opposed to having a normal W-2 job. At the time, I was the only one with a W-2 job, so they were kind of looking at an array of income, and the other two women also owned first homes, primary homes, so there was a lot of things to consider. It probably took us maybe 6 to 8 weeks to kind of get through all of those hoops, but once we're on the other side of that, you have your pre-approval letter, and then it was just up to house hunting.
What about mortgage rates? When a bank finds out that you're doing this with others, is the mortgage rate, and especially if you're looking at maybe a second home, as some might be doing, is that a little bit more expensive?
It's more than a primary home, but it's not looked at as an investment property quite the same way as if you were going to be using it just for rental income, like a strict investor would be doing. A second home has a little bit more of a favorable interest rate. So, you know, at the time it was 2017, rates aren't what they were, but we're still, you know, right around 4, which isn't too crazy.
So what kind of legal issues can this raise if you decide, you're laughing.
Yep.
So, okay, if you decide that you want to keep the home and maybe your two friends say, well, I want to sell my share.
Yeah, so these were all conversations we really had to talk through beforehand. It also led us to have a conversation with a lawyer who drew up a contract that we all agreed to the terms on, of what happens in those instances, what happens if one of us passed away. So there are definitely things you have to kind of talk about and make sure you're on the same page about before you go into an agreement together. We kind of joke that we feel like we're, you know, married on paper because we own this big thing together.
Well, what happens if one of your friends falls behind on their share of a payment? What does that do to the friendship, and what does that do to the credit score?
Yeah, well, because we're just paying out of one account, it's really up to all three of us. It's not that, you know, if one person can't contribute to the bank account for some reason that month, it wouldn't really affect the overall since we have just one account that the payment's coming out of. But, you know, these types of conversations definitely affect the friendship. And it's really why I stress that when people ask me for advice on this, that people have kind of a professional relationship with their friends before they go into this kind of agreement. You need to be able to talk about money really openly. It can't just be, you know, your girlfriends that you get brunch with. It needs to be a more serious relationship than that.
Are you seeing this becoming more popular? As we mentioned, I mean, the you know, you're looking at maybe $1 million, $2 million, $3 million to get some kind of home in the San Francisco area if you're lucky. So are you seeing this more in big cities, or are you seeing this in the Midwest or smaller towns?
Well, I'm a realtor based in Philadelphia, and while I don't think it's the majority of homes that I'm selling to my clients, we're starting to see these types of relationships be sprinkled through our clients. So I know a teammate recently had a client who was moving from the West Coast to Philadelphia for grad school, couldn't afford the down payment with her stipend salary. And so two friends jumped in and looked at it as an investment opportunity, and the three of them co-bought together. So she can live in the home, they can rent the other rooms out, and it becomes a cash flow experience. So, you know, I think people are beginning to see the value in it. And millennials in general probably don't feel like they have that many opportunities to invest since they're not walking around, you know, with a 20% down payment like our parents did.
This, I know from friends and family I have overseas, is something that they've been doing there for a number of years, and it seems to have taken off. Do you think this is going to become more common in the next 5, 6, 7 years here in the U.S.?
Yeah, I think with house prices being what they are and people starting to see that this is a possibility and there's agreements and terms and contracts you can draw up to not make it so scary, you know, why wouldn't people kind of make their situation a little bit better when they're going out into this crazy market?
Have you guys gotten into any fights over money or over payments?
Me and my co-owner?
Yes.
No, we've never fought about money. We tend to fight more about repairs and contractors.
Over who? And what about when it comes to what you want in the house and how it looks and design? Is that, do you butt heads on something like that as well?
Yeah, well, I always joke that it's three women making decisions about just curtains. So it's, you know, three women's perspectives on every rug, on everything in the hall. But it's not so much fighting. We look at it as a collaboration.
All right, Kate, appreciate your time this morning. That is Kate McCann, who's a realtor at Philly Home Girls, who just bought her own home with a friend. And as we mentioned, that is becoming more and more popular here in the U.S., especially with home prices in the Bay Area topping $1.3 million on average. We're going to head to Walnut Creek. We've got